ओके फॉर टुडेज सेशन फर्स्ट सेशन ऑन स्टेबिलाइजेशन इफ यू रिमेंबर वी स्पोक ऑफ स्टेबिलाइज्ड सब बेसिस एंड इन द वेरी फर्स्ट डे एंड देन वी आल्सो सेड दैट द सॉइल्स व्हिच आर वीकर दे मे रिक्वायर टू बी इम्प्रूव्ड नाउ दिस इज प्रैक्टिकली वन वेरी बिग डील दैट द सॉइल subgrade should at the first instance be prepared of the existing or available soil because that is going to reduce the cost of the construction. In case you are required to get the soil transported to the site, then the cost will become higher. But sometimes the transportation to the site is unavoidable if you have to increase the level of the existing level of the ground to obtain the road surface. So in that case you have to in any case put into the filling, so we'll have to get the soil from outside. But in most of the cases when we attempt to use the available soil, so first step is evaluation of the properties of the soil. Now we have to find out which are the soil which may require to be improved and which are the soils which cannot be improved or are not worth even improvement. जैसे हम लोग जानते हैं कि जो सागर का जल है जितने भी सागर के तट के ऊपर cities हैं या शहर हैं they do not use that water कि सागर किनारे ही पीने का पानी नहीं है कम है क्योंकि वो इतना ज़्यादा खारा है उसमें इतनी ज़्यादा impurities हैं that the cost of removing those impurities is so high that it is better to look for an alternate source and use that water. So similarly, in some of the cases, the cost of stabilization or improvement may be high, and in that case, we may be required to get the soil from an outside source. But you have to first assess that whether the soil need improvement. And if it need improvement, what type of improvement can be done and how it can be done and how much is the quantities and what will be the cost of the improvement of the soil. So that is what we look from the improvement of the soil. One of the major issue is that the type of the soil. So jaise humne kaha gravel soils or sandy soils, they are good soil, so they will not require any improvement. They can require improvement in terms of compaction, but not otherwise. So, unko agar wo loose hain, they can be compacted and you can use the same soils without any need to modify or improve the soil. But the compaction is not taken as improvement. Compaction is considered to be a normal phenomena in the construction. Some of the soils which may be very loose, say silty soils, if they are loose and they are compacted, they may improve and exhibit good strength characteristics. Now, which characteristics are important for road consideration? We said the most important characteristic, for the road design purpose is the CBR value, California bearing ratio value. And then the related parameters are liquid limit and plasticity limits. On which their behavior on shrinkage, swelling, and changes in the strength will depend upon. So, if I zero down to the parameters, so I am not very keen. If say a sand at lesser density gives me higher CBR value, so I am okay with that. Contrary to a clay or silt. Which even exhibit higher density but low CBR value. So it is quite possible sometime that some of the soils may have low densities. By density I mean maximum dry density and still they have higher CBR value. For example, sand. Now we get something like a Tibba sand from a place called Rewari and we find that the densities are low, something like 1.53, 1.56, like this, or 1.6, but not beyond that. And the CBR value is something like 8.7, soaked value I'm saying, unsoaked value is still very, very high. So that is okay with us. And contrarily, we get clays or silts which exhibit dry density to the tune of 1.8 to 1.84, and they can show the CBR value to be something like 3 or 4 like that. So this means that I am more concerned with this 10th parameter, primarily CBR value, and also the plasticity characteristics of the fine grained soil, which are exhibited by liquid limit, plastic limit, then derived value is plasticity index. And if you want to do some more studies when you encounter black cotton soils or expansive soil, then we go for the swell test as well. Okay, so let us see that I have got a soil on site and it needs I found that the CBR value is low, so maybe less than 3. Now which value we say it is low? 2, 3, 4, 5. The earlier codes were very not very specific about it, and therefore CBR, you know, something like 2, 3, 4, and the design codes were available even for CBR value 2% or higher. So this means that if design code is available, so you could use that CBR value and place an overlay as per the design charts. But now the code suggests that the CBR value should not be less than 4% and preferably 8%. Now why 8%? 8% because it is a desirable, it is not a mandatory. 8%, if you have higher strength subgrade, so the chances of development of ruts, waviness, undulations, they will reduce. In a few states, you know, there was a lot of studies, and then centrally the MORTH, IERC and the concerned agencies, they compiled that data together. It was a big project, so studied that. And then they found that where the CBR value of the soils were higher, the occurrence of such kind of defect was lesser. So the recommendation was made that it should be higher than 8, preferably. But in one state, you know, without reading the details, they have made it more or less mandatory that the CBR should be 8. Below that, you cannot use. So we get some kind of those requests that our CBR sub 8 only chahiye. Otherwise, you need to improve or whatever you do. The further we expect that, you know, something, if the CBR value is less than 4 or 5, then the soil is not good enough. And if you want to use actually the soil with low CBR value, then we are required to put a cushion, granular cushion above that, which is not actually the part of the subgrade. So you will have to place an additional layer. So again, the cost of additional layer is going to be higher, क्योंकि आपको जो CBR low है, 2 से अगर low है, तो 3 से low है, so we say, no, it's not acceptable, less than 3 is not acceptable. So go for some improvement or go for a layer which will be a sandwich type of the layer. Now once you decide that the soil needs to be improved, and then we see that what are the possibilities of improvement. The first alternative which come to us is the improvement by stabilization. Stabilization means addition of another chemical or any material to the soil which will modify its property and enhance the its strength characteristics. You can add some other type of soil also. Suppose I have a clay soil and if I add sandy soil to that, so that can also bring the improvement because now the soil composition will change. But that means you are required to bring sand and get it mixed, which also become a not a very simple process. So obviously from practical point of view, then the stabilization becomes the first choice. Which are the materials for stabilization? One is cement, second is lime, a third is bitumen. Then there are certain chemicals, but most common are the lime and cement. Okay. Now, once you decide that lime is to be used or cement is to be used, we need to know that what should be the percentage of these to be added, whether I should add 2%, 3%, 4%, 5%, what should be the dosage. Then what type of lime should be used, what type of cement should be used. So those questions will come to your mind. But first let us decide, say I decide to go for stabilization using cement, say, for example. Okay, let me ask you a question. You know, if you were to choose between cement and lime, okay, I'll ask you a little later. Now, how do I decide that what is the percentage of cement I'm going to add to that? To do that, you'll have to do a series of laboratory investigations. What are those investigations? You have to first decide that what will be the starting percentage. So you can start with the percentage of 2, then give an increment of 2%, so 2, 4, 6, 8%. That means you are required to prepare samples at 2, 4, 6, 8% of the cement being added. Or maybe that if you are experienced, you can start with say a little higher value. If you expect that 3%, less than 3% is not going to work, so you could start at 3%, give an increment of 1.5% or 2%. And likewise, at least you should select 4 to 5 percentages, trial percentages, at which you are going to treat the sample of the soil. Now, once you decide those percentages, then the next job is that to first conduct the Proctor compaction test. So from the Proctor compaction test, what is going to happen? You are going to get a data that how much is the improvement in the density by addition of the cement. We expect improvement in the density. So again, what you can do that you can study the increment in the density by addition of the cement, and then you can conclude that from that by addition of so much percent of cement, the increment which I get is okay. It is not necessary that what will happen that in the beginning the density will increase higher, then the increment will go slower. So yani beyond adding a certain percentage, you will not get any additional useful benefit by addition of the extra cement. So something now like you want to take tea, so I give you a tea without sugar, you add half of spoon of the sugar, you find it is not still good, you add another half, one spoon good enough, you add one more spoon, it goes down, the taste goes down. So one spoon is good for you. Likewise, so likewise for the different soils, there would be some value where you find that the benefit which we wanted to obtain by addition of the cement is reasonably obtained. Now this first test is going to give you a basis to select some percentages. Jaise maine kaha tha, ke for a beginner it may be difficult to select, main 2% pe lu, 3% pe lu, ya 4% se start karu. So when you do this test, so you will get some value ke isse kam percentage add karne koi fayda nahi hai. So for the other test, then you can take that as a starting value. तो मान लीजिए मैंने देखा कि 6% के ऊपर डेंसिटी इंक्रीज हुई है, सो देयर इज नो फन दैट यू नो द अदर टेस्ट आल्सो रिपीट फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 2%, सो आई कैन स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 3% एंड गो फॉर द इंक्रीमेंट टू सेव माय टाइम एंड एनर्जी. द अदर टेस्ट व्हिच यू आर गोइंग टू डू आर CBR टेस्ट एंड वी आल्सो डू अनकन्फाइंड कंप्रेशन स्ट्रेंथ टेस्ट. तो ये दोनों टेस्ट करना जरूरी है फॉर स्टेबिलाईजेशन. हालांकि अनकन्फाइंड कंप्रेशन स्ट्रेंथ का जो डाटा है वो हम डिजाइन में यूज नहीं करते हैं, बट वेन वी आर गोइंग टू असर्टेन द डोजेज फॉर स्टेबिलाईजेशन, अनकन्फाइंड कंप्रेशन स्ट्रेंथ टेस्ट आर वेरी वेरी यूजफुल. सो वी डू टू टेस्ट, स्ट्रेंथ टेस्ट, अनकन्फाइंड कंप्रेशन स्ट्रेंथ एंड CBR स्ट्रेंथ. सो दीज सैम्पल्स एटलीस्ट यू शुड प्रिपेयर 2 to 3 सैम्पल्स for each of the dosage By dosage means, you know, percentage of cement. So preferably minimum of 2 samples bribe at each dosage, and then you can find out the data. So wherever, suppose now you want to say obtain a CBR value of 5%. So corresponding to the cement content which gives you a value 5 or higher, first then you can select that as a cement content. Lekin agar aapko 8% CBR aa jati hai to kisi percent pe, to then you don't have to go for that addition. To aap kam level ke upar addition karke aapka kaam chala sakte hain. So it is based on that investigation and your requirement, because at different percentages of cement you get different increment, and accordingly whatever value you want you can select that. Now suppose you have now come to a definite percentage. मान लीजिए हमने कहा 4% के ऊपर आपका stabilization करना है, 4% of the cement. Now 4% of the cement means this ratio is by weight, number one, not by volume. तो 4% by weight आपने add करना है with respect to the dry soil. Again, dry soil. You did this investigation in the laboratory, that you took some sample of dry soil, added 4% of the cement, and this was found to be optimum. Now what we, how do we achieve that in field? This is a big, very, very challenging triangle of the task. So I remember, you know, first when we get it done, many times the even field engineers are not able to find out what is the quantity of the cement which would be required for the stabilization. This is a very typical issue. I will use the board and then explain how actually we do that.
So let us see. Now my concern is to find out what quantity of cement would be required. So suppose I found that 4% is the optimum value of cement to be added. Now you will have to first demarcate the area. Say this is the road, the grade which has to be installed, right? So I demarcate that this portion is to be stabilized in the first row. So let me see, they say that this is say 500 meter. You actually can't, you know, do for very, very long lengths practically in a single row, but let us say 500 meter. And say this is a 3.5 meter length, width of the section of this window. Now obviously if I say 500 meter, 3.5 meter, so I get yes. Okay. Is it clear? Audible? आवाज आ रही है? ठीक आ रही है?
यस सर।
ओके। Now I need to go. Okay, so what is the thickness in which I am going to get it compacted? The thickness is going to be, as you said, is no more than 300 mm. So let us say I am going to compact 300 mm thickness. So compacted thickness is 30 cm. Thickness 30 cm or 0.3 meter. Okay. Now, if I multiply 0.3 meter with this, then the volume would be.
Hello.
Yes.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Sir, we are not getting you. Big disturbance in the volume. We are not able to hear you, sir.
Are you able to hear now?
Yeah, now we are.
So okay, we'll do that.
Sir, now it is audible.
अभी सुन सकते हैं? Can you hear now?
It's audible now, sir.
It's audible. Okay. तो मैंने mic position change किया, right? Okay. Okay, now let me then repeat. So suppose we want to stabilize the road subgrade, then first of all it has to be done in sections. So you have to demarcate the section. Suppose I demarcate a section of 500 meter length and say one lane I do one and second lane I will do second time. So one lane width is say 3.5 meter. So I demarcate 500 meter by 3.5 meter. So the area becomes 1750 meter square. And now since we say that the thickness in which is to be compacted cannot be more than 300 mm, so compacted thickness, so 0.3 meter is the compacted thickness. So 1750 into 0.3 meter, it becomes 525 meter cube, right? So this much is the volume of soil to be stabilized, right? Now after actually on the basis of the laboratory testing, I know what is the dry density, maximum dry density. So say maximum dry density was found to be, MDD was found to be say 1.6 gram per cc. Okay, now if this is 1.6 gram per cc, then this is equal to actually 1600 kg per meter cube. Is it okay? So 1600 kg per meter cube is the maximum dry density, and 525 meter cube is the total volume. So if you multiply by this, this is 840000 kg of the soil. क्यों साहब ठीक है ये? 525 meter cube soil हो गई और उसको हमने 1600 kg per meter से multiply किया तो 840,000 kg of the soil. Now if the cement was 4%, so 4 by 100, ये आपका आ जाएगा 8400 into 4, 33,600 kilo. 33,600 किलो सो वन बैग ऑफ सीमेंट इज 50 kg सो यू विल रिक्वायर 672 बैग्स Now just to review, the maximum dry density which we found was 1.6 gram per cc or that is 1600 kg per meter cube. So multiply this density with the volume to be stabilized 525 into 1600 kg. So this becomes 840,000 kg of the soil. Then multiply by 4% which is the quantity of cement we said to be used. So 4% of this is equal to 33,600 kg, each bag is 50 kg and I am required to put 672 bags, right? So 672 bag cement ke honge, to mera ye jo hai stabilization, one lane width for half a kilometer, wo pura ho jayega. So this means, ab aage kya karna hai? Ye to humne determine kar liya. अब जो 3.5 मीटर की विड्थ है उसको हम फॉर एग्जाम्पल 3 रोज में डिवाइड कर देते हैं. 3 रोज, यू कैन हैव 2 रोज और यू कैन हैव 3 रोज. 1, और लेट अस से हमने 2 रोज लगा दी, 2 रोज डिमार्क कर दिया. सो व्हेन आई पुट 2 रोज, सो 500 इनटू 2 रोज इट बिकम्स 1000 मीटर. ओके, तो 672 बैग मुझे 1000 मीटर में लगाना है. तो 1000 मीटर में 672 बैग, तो बैग की स्पेसिंग कितनी हो जाएगी? ईच बैग हैज टू बी स्पेस्ड एट ए डिस्टेंस 1000 बाई 672, so this is going to be roughly 1.5 meter. So 1.5 meter spacing के ऊपर आपको bags place करने पड़ेंगे, 1.5 meter spacing के ऊपर. हाँ जी, is it clear? Let us know from our Dronacharya ji. ये बात clear हुई? Oh, we had got good attendance. Yes. Is this point clear? How to find out the quantity of the stabilizing chemical or cement?
Sir.
जी.
सर, ये 1.6 जो डेंसिटी ली है वो स्टेबलाइज्ड सॉइल की है या ओनली
स्टेबलाइज्ड की है?
स्टेबलाइज्ड की है. तो ये जो मास निकला है तो वो सॉइल एंड सीमेंट दोनों का मिक्स मास आएगा ना?
वो आप ठीक कह रहे हो कि वो दोनों का मिक्स होके आएगा, लेकिन प्रैक्टिकली ऐसे ही हम करते हैं तो कोई दिक्कत नहीं आती, क्योंकि जो हम रेफरेंस जो हमने कंपैक्ट देखिए, जब हम कंपैक्ट कर लेंगे तो स्टेबलाइज सॉइल ही कंपैक्ट होगी ना. फाइनली जो हमारा प्रोडक्ट है वो स्टेबलाइज सॉइल है प्रोडक्ट. तो स्टेबलाइज सॉइल में सॉइल भी है और वो सीमेंट भी है. तो हमने जो लेबोरेटरी में स्टडी किया था उसमें देखा कि ये जो बेस्ट वैल्यू आई है ऑप्टिमम, वो 1.6 ग्राम पर सीसी आई थी. तो उसमें यानी सॉइल भी है और सीमेंट भी था. तो यहाँ पे ये सॉइल जो है हमने इसका उसके हिसाब से कॉम्पैक्टेड के हिसाब से ये हमने टोटल का क्वांटिटी निकाल ली कितनी थी सॉइल. तो थोड़ी सी वेरिएशन होगी बट दैट इज माइनर, वो फील्ड में वो कोई मायने नहीं रखती इतना. ओके यस, ये
दूसरा
नोएडा से. यस, हाँ जी, क्लियर है जी?
हाँ सर, क्लियर है. हाँ सर क्लियर है.
ओके गुड. अब आपसे मैं ये बताऊं कि ये हमने चार पांच जगह करवाया ये काम, मतलब एज कंसल्टेंट. तो एट नन ऑफ द प्लेसेस आई कुड सी दैट दे वर एबल टू फाइंड आउट कि हाउ टू डू द स्टेबलाइजेशन, कैसे हम क्वांटिटी निकालें, कितना चाहिए. 3% तो ओके है. आई रिमेम्बर द रिकमेंडेशन वॉज 3%, बट हाउ टू डू दैट. So then we gave them this kind of formulation that you demarcate it. अब क्या करते हैं, अब हम बोलते हैं भाई इतने बैग्स लाओ और वहाँ रख दो. उसके ऊपर हम दो लाइन लगा के वो दो बैग रखवा दिए. And then you get the bags opened and get them distributed manually. But before that, before actually you place the bags, you will be required to loosen the soil. आपको soil को loosen करना पड़ेगा. अब loosen कितना करना है वो भी आपको calculate करना पड़ेगा. अब वो कैसे, उसके लिए सबसे पहले हमारे पास ये compacted density आ गया. Now I determine the field density. जो actual existing density of soil है वो हम determine करते हैं. तो मुझे ये पता है कि कॉम्पैक्टेड में मेरा इतना केजी सॉइल लग रहा है, तो लूज डेंसिटी के हिसाब से वो कितना केजी सॉइल है और उसकी डेप्थ कितनी होगी. सो व्हेन द कॉम्पैक्टेड डेप्थ इज 30 सेंटीमीटर, तो लूज एंड डेप्थ विल बी मच मोर. इट कुड बी 40, 42, 45, कुछ भी बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ कैलकुलेशन. सो आई हैव टू देन लूजन द सॉइल अप टू दैट एक्सटेंट. तो वो हम रोटावेटर से या हैरो, जैसे एग्रीकल्चर में हैरो यूज की जाती हैं, और उससे वो यूज करके उसको हम लूजनिंग की जाती है सॉइल की. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डू हाउ इट इज बीइंग डन. सो फर्स्ट स्टेप इज लूजनिंग ऑफ द सॉइल. नाउ व्हेन यू विल लूजन द सॉइल, इट मे बी मॉइस्ट, इट विल बी वेट, सो इट मे बी यू नो कमिंग इन द फॉर्म ऑफ द लंप्स. अगर आप क्लेई सॉइल को कर रहे हो लूसन, तो ये लंप फॉर्म में आएगी. जैसे टिलिंग करते हैं खेतों में तो मोटे मोटे फॉर्म में वो नजर आता है. अगर आप उसको ऐसे छोड़ देंगे तो आपका ये सीमेंट या लाइम उसमें मिक्स नहीं होगा. सो द नेक्स्ट स्टेप इज अलाउ इट टू ड्राई. यू मे हैव टू गिव वन डे, यू हैव टू गिव टू डेज, और मे बी हाफ ए डे, डिपेंडिंग अपॉन दी एनवायरमेंटल कंडीशन. अगर सनी डे है तो आपने सुबह खोला, शाम तक वो ड्राई हो जाएगा. सो वंस इट गेट्स ड्राइड, बिकॉज यू कैनॉट मिक्स इफेक्टिवली एनी टाइप ऑफ द मटीरियल इन टू ए वेट सॉइल. सो वंस इट गेट ड्राइड, देन यू आर टू रिक्वायर टू अगेन पाउडर इट, ब्रेक द लंप्स. टू ब्रेक द लंप्स यू आर टू मूव ए मशीनरी. आप ट्रैक्टर चला दीजिए, कोई लाइट व्हीकल चला दीजिए, नॉट द रोलर, नॉट द रोलर, वी डोंट सजेस्ट ए रोलर. अगर कुछ नहीं है तो, क्योंकि रोलर कंपैक्ट कर देगा. सो एनी व्हीकल, टायर्ड व्हीकल यू कैन यूज, बड़ा कोई चला के. नाउ द लंप्स विल गेट ब्रोकन, बट व्हेन यू मूव द व्हीकल अगेन इट विल गेट स्लाइटली कॉम्पैक्टेड. देन वी अगेन लूजन इट बाय द सेम मैनर, हैरो से या कोई और रोटावेटर से और डिस्क से या कोई भी सूटेबल इक्विपमेंट से कर सकते हैं. सो पहले आपने उसको एक्सकेवेट किया टू द डिजायर्ड डेप्थ, ड्राई किया, लंप्स ब्रेक किए, फिर उसको दोबारा से ओपन किया यूजिंग द हैरोस. नाउ योर मटेरियल, नाउ योर सॉइल इज रेडी टू गेट मिक्स्ड विद द सीमेंट और लाइम. फिर हमने वो बैग्स इस फॉर्म में, जैसे हमने बताया ये क्वांटिटी कैलकुलेट करके, वो बैग्स रखे और उसको ओपन कर दिया. आफ्टर ओपनिंग इट देन यू मैनुअली स्प्रेड इट यूजिंग बास्केट्स और मैनुअली विद जो कस्सी या कोई भी ऐसा सूटेबल है वो उसको यूनिफॉर्मली स्प्रेड करके. सो व्हाट यू आर गोइंग टू सी इज दैट एवरीथिंग इज कवर्ड विद द लाइम और सीमेंट. नाउ द मिक्सिंग इज टू बी डन. नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू project where you can see that the lime stabilization is actually being done. So we can see the presentation here now. Okay, you can see that this soil which is to be stabilized, you can see that the bags are on the sides. Ye emptied bag hai yahan pe, or they have been emptied at the site following the same procedure which is done. Now what you see here is a dozer. This is a dozer. So dozer is going to first do some kind of rough mixing. So dozer movement will take place, and then it is going to take something along with it and do the mixing. So the dozer operations are being done. Of course, this is not very effective method. And now first you will see, when you are going to apply the lime, you will see everything is white on the top. So it's good, but then you find out that how it goes about. So this equipment moves to and fro a couple of times, 6-8 times, and then gradually the mixing will be done. But as I said to you before, the better mixing is done with harrows. I'll show you that equipment in another presentation. So ye ab ye operations iska under progress hai, movement hai dozer ki to and fro. So it is carrying the material along with it. And leveling is also done, क्योंकि जब first step में जब आप soil को loosen करोगे तो उसकी leveling नहीं होती है. तो dozer को हमने इसलिए use किया है, जैसे हमने पहले कहा था that you need to provide a camber at right in the beginning. So dozer, the rotavator we can only open it up. लेकिन अगर आपको camber देना है तो फिर ये dozer जो है वो काम dozer से होगा. So this is a overall site. You can see that इसमें हमने दोनों ये, this is actually a service lane. ये two lane road नहीं है, service lane है ये. आप ये जो right में देख रहे हैं ये main road है, तो ये service lane है. So once you give certain number of movements, you will gradually find that the lime gets mixed with the soil. This would be evident that there will be a uniformity in the texture. So the white texture, gradually it will get into, you know, a kind of brownish tinge. Gradually it will keep on getting brownish tinge. Now at the stage you think that dry mixing has taken place, now we will do the watering. Now the process of watering is to be done. Mixing will be effective only when the soil is dry. Remember that. If the soil was wet, mixing will not be effective. So here now we start watering. What you are going to see is not a very, very precise or accurate method, but this is the actual one. So any case, I'm going to show you that. Now here you can see that the soil and they are mixed together, perfectly mixed together. On the side you may see this is some excessive soil because of the dozer movement. So jo excess tha thoda wo side pe aa jata hai, so there will be a little bit higher on the sides, and that we expect let it be because the shoulder become stronger. Ab ye watering ho raha hai, so you can see that a tanker is used. But this watering is being done by a pipe and not a sprinkler. Ideally we use a sprinkler. Wo jaise aapko kal bitumen sprayer dikhaya tha, so sprinkler is like that. It has nozzles, in that you can just control the quantity of water flowing and then allow the vehicle to move. Isme our effort is that on the very first go the requisite quantity of water should fall upon the सॉयल बिकॉज वी आर नॉट गोइंग टू रिपीट द मूवमेंट ऑफ द ट्रक. एक ही बार में कोशिश होनी चाहिए कि जितनी रिक्विजिट क्वांटिटी है वो उसमें जाना चाहिए. नाउ दिस इज अ टेरिबली चैलेंजिंग टास्क. आपने लेबोरेटरी में डिटरमिन किया से 10.5% इज द ऑप्टिमम बाइंडर कंटेंट. हाउ डू यू एंश्योर 10.5% इन द फील्ड? Very difficult, honestly. It's practically not feasible. You can zero down, close down, but not achieve, you know, 10.5 exactly. So that is why in our presentation yesterday we said that it could be +1% or -2% depending on the weather conditions. But usually we would not keep on the lower side. We would try that it may be slightly on the higher side. And practically, it's the experience. You could do the calculation. कि मेरे टैंकर में इतनी क्वांटिटी है, इतना एरिया है, इतनी डेप्थ है, इतने परसेंट के हिसाब से इतना वाटर, इतने क्यूबिक मीटर वाटर लगना चाहिए. आप प्रैक्टिकली ये कैलकुलेशन जरूर कर सकते हैं. पर वो कैसे गिरेगा उसके लिए आपको नोजल कितना खोलना है, ट्रक की स्पीड कितनी रखनी है, ये बहुत डिफिकल्ट टास्क है. सो बाय वर्च्यू ऑफ द यू नो द एक्सपीरियंस देन यू विजुअली से दैट ओके इट्स गुड इनफ. फ्लडिंग नहीं होनी चाहिए. द वाटर थोड़ा सरफेस के ऊपर रहेगा, धीरे धीरे नीचे जाएगा. सो बेस्ड ऑन दोज विजुअल ऑब्जर्वेशन देन वी ask the truck to move slower or faster or open the nozzles to allow more water to fall. So this truck of tanker, this tanker is used to water the piche uske sprinkler hai. You can see the picture. Yeah, so you can see now that after sprinkling water there is some water which you can see on the surface. Now this is what we are looking for. We are not looking for actually the dry surface. To halka sa pani jo upar hai hoga to wo dheere dheere niche jayega and some of that will then get evaporated. So a little extra water is okay, but it should not be that excessive that it starts flowing. If it starts flowing then you are, you know, chemical or cement will also start flowing. अब फिर से जो है वो दोबारा से हमने वाटरिंग के बाद फिर से मिक्सिंग किया, क्योंकि पानी जो है ऑन इट्स ओन यूनिफॉर्मली स्प्रेड नहीं करेगा. सो देन द मटेरियल इज मिक्स्ड अगेन. सो यूजिंग द सेम फिर से मिक्स किया ताकि वाटर सॉयल एंड द स्टेबिलाइजर सीमेंट और लाइम हेयर इन दिस केस इट गेट मिक्स्ड यूनिफॉर्मली. So again you will have to give say 4-5 passes minimum, 6 passes to achieve that uniformity in the mixing. And you can now see that it is uniformly mixed. There will be isolated patches where some chemical is a little bit higher. And now actually this is what you see is it is a compacted state as well. This is has been compacted. And after compaction you will find that the color is more or less brownish, light brown with some white tinges. So white tinges is that of the lime, but now after what we saw, which was white, absolutely white in the beginning, gradually is close to the brown color. You can see the soil also in the background and you can see what is the color of the mixing. So a visual inspection will tell you that whether the it has been done uniformly or not. And if you find that at some places there are the soil didn't get it, so again manually you can add up some lime over there and make up good for that. So this is the compaction here has been done using a roller which is having a drum and on the rear tires, two tires and one drum in the front. because the tires give a kind of kneading action, the drum give a compaction effort. So for soils, that act as a good combination. So the team which was there, now this guy in the white cap is from the company side, and here you can see me along with some of our fellow postgraduate students who wanted to learn how this process takes place. So that is the on-site experience, learning experience for them. And yes. So after the completion, you always get a smile on your face if the job is done well. So that's about how we do the stabilization at the site.